This pivot table is good to summarize the data, but this report can further be enriched if we highlight the peaks and drops using color or icons. And we will use color through conditional formatting. Applying conditional formatting in pivot table is different from applying conditional formatting in normal data range. In this video, I will discuss how to use conditional formatting in pivot table. Welcome to SPC Excel Guides. Before discussing conditional formatting in pivot table, I would like to suggest you to watch the conditional formatting in data range. Link is given in the description box. In this pivot table, we will apply conditional formatting. To apply conditional formatting, select a cell in the value field. Let me choose this cell. Let's suppose our task is to highlight those cells which are above 5, but not the total rows. Go to conditional formatting under home menu, select highlight sales rules and click greater than option. In this text box, type 5, click OK. A single cell is conditionally formatted. We need to apply conditional formatting in all the cells. You can see a small box, formatting options. Click this. This will give us three options: selected cells, all cells showing sum of value cells values, and all cells showing sum of the value cells values for name and product. Let us first choose the second option. All the cells are highlighted with the selected color, including the total rows, but we don't need highlighted total rows. The subtotal rows are highlighting because we have selected the option all cells showing sum of value cells values. You can remove the conditional formatting from the rows total. Select all the subtotal rows by clicking here. When this black right-sided arrow appears, and then go to conditional formatting, clear rules, and click clear rules from the selected cells. The conditional formatting is cleared from the subtotal rows. Our problem is solved temporarily. It is not the correct process. Let's take an example. In this data source, I have few more rows with different employee name. I want to test what will happen if the pivot table rows increase in number. This data is in table format. Therefore, we can increase the range by dragging the table range like this. For detailed information, please watch the last video. Now, the range is increased. Go to pivot table and refresh the table by right click and refresh. The new employee is inserted, but this data is not highlighted. Although our rules in conditional formatting was to highlight cells which are greater than 5. Open the conditional formatting window. You can notice that the dotted lines showing the coverage area of this conditional formatting. It is not including the newly added data. So, if you want to highlight all the data, then use this second option. But if you use the third option, then this problem will not arise. Let me repeat all the steps again. Then I will show you how to apply icon sets in pivot table. I will clear all the conditional formatting from the entire set. I will reduce the data range and refresh the data. Apply conditional formatting and type 5 in this text box. Click OK. From this formatting option box, I will select the third option, conditional formatting applied. Go to dataset, increase the data range. In pivot table, refresh the pivot table. And I'm done. This data is automatically included by the conditional formatting. Now, if I want to apply icon sets, all the previous steps to be done, and additionally, we need to add few rules in this conditional formatting. So, go to conditional formatting, select three colored icon sets. I choose arrows. From this formatting option box, I select the third option, all cells showing sum of value cells values for name and products. We need to set the rules to these icon sets. Go to Conditional Formatting Manage Rules. From Conditional Formatting Rules Manager window, select the rule and click Edit Rule option. This will change the conditions. So we will work in this part. Change the type to number. Then set the boundary for green upward arrow. Let it be 30. Type 30 in this value box. Hit tab. For horizontal yellow arrow, let type 10. Hit tab. The current rule is, if the sale value is greater than 30, then green upward arrow. If the sale value is between 10 to less than 30, then yellow arrow, and below 10 is red downward arrow. Click OK. Then apply. Then click the OK button again. The pivot table is formatted with icon sets. If you don't like these icon sets, you can always change it. Go to Conditional Formatting, Manage Rules, and select the rule. Then click on the Edit Rule button. You can now select any icons from this icon style drop down. Let's suppose we choose this flag. Click OK and hit Apply. The icons are changed. If you want traffic lights, you can use it. If you want to change the rule, you can always do it from this part. This is how conditional formatting is applied to pivot table. I hope you have enjoyed this video tutorial. Please like and click the subscribe button and click the bell icon to get modern Excel tutorial notifications. Thank you for your interest. See you in the next video in another topic.